Welcome learners. So this is the first video lecture on organizational behavior. This video lecture is divided into two parts. After completion of each part, you need to self-check your progress. At the end of the lecture, you need to participate in the discussion forum so that you can communicate with us about your level of understanding. So part one deals with the concept of human behavior, nature of organizational behavior, concept of self-theory, and concept of ability. And the part 2 of the video lecture will deal with the concept of learning and learning theories, then meaning and definition of values, and concept of attitudes. So the learning outcomes are, after completion of this first part of the presentation, you will be able to state the concept of human behavior. Then we'll discuss about the nature of organizational behavior. Then we'll discuss the state of concept of self-ability, self-theory. And at last, we'll discuss about the concept of ability. So let's start. What is organizational behavior? Human behavior starts with a set of fundamental concepts revolving around the nature of people and organization. As we know that the behavior of people as an individual is different from the behavior from their behavior in the organization. So in general, we can see the nature of people varies in these attributes. First one is individual differences. Each individual is different from the other one, so their behavior pattern will also vary. Then comes the perception. The same thing can be perceived by different people differently. Then a whole person. We always have this tendency to make it as a whole. Suppose we are getting some information, then we try to make it as a whole information. Then motivated behaviors. Some behaviors like suppose increment in salary, some other facilities are motivating factors for some persons. On the other hand, appraisal, suppose someone is very much good at some work. So if you are praising that person in front of other people, that may also be a motivating factor for that person. So the motivating behavior also varies from person to person. Then desire of involvement. If you involve some people in any kind of work, feeling of belongingness is also a very important factor which influences in organizational behavior. Then comes the value of the person, that is ethical treatment. People desire to be treated differently from other factors of production like land, capital, technology, because they are of a higher order in the universe. So we just don't like to be treated as a material. Because of this distinction, they want to be treated with respect and dignity. And increasingly, they demand it for employers. They want to be valued for their skills, abilities, and to be provided with the opportunities to develop themselves. So in any organization, it is the responsibility of the employer to look after their employees in proper way. So our nature of organizational behavior, the organization behavior as a field of study means that it is a distinct area of expertise with a common body of knowledge. It studies three determinants of behavior in organizations, that is individual behavior, group behavior, and structure. In another video lecture, I have already explained about group and team behavior. So in addition, organizational behavior applies to the knowledge gained about individuals, groups, and the effect of structure on behavior in order to make organizations work more effectively. So to make an organization more successful, we need to consider about the individual's behavior, group behavior, and the structure of the organization. Now let us discuss the concept of self-theory. Self-theory is composed of perception of I or me, that is, it is concentrated on the myself. The following four factors are included in self-theory. First one is self-image. By nature, every person has certain belief about what or who he or she is. In other words, self-image is one image of own self. Then comes the ideal self. The ideal self refers to what one would like to be look like. The basic line of difference between the self-image and ideal self is that the former indicates the reality of a person, whereas the latter implies the ideality of the person. That means what we want to be. That is our ideal self. Then comes the looking glass self. This refers to how others perceive the individual. In other words, this means the way an individual thinks people perceive about him or her, and not the way people actually sees him. And the last component is the real self. The real self is what one actually is. People perceive the same situation differently depending on their conception of the situation. Then comes the concept of ability. So what is ability? Basically, ability is the capacity of a person to perform certain task. It is a current assessment of what one can do. An individual's overall abilities are essentially made up of two sets of factors. One is your intellectual ability and another one is your physical ability. So intellectual abilities are those needed to perform mental activities or thinking, reasoning and problem solving. Again, specific physical abilities are needed to successfully doing some less skilled and more standardized jobs. For example, jobs in which success demands stamina, manual dexterity, etc. Or similar talents require management to identify an employee's physical capabilities. Generally, to perform a managerial task, we require more intellectual abilities. Then suppose for defense personnel, for security personnel, we require more kind of physical abilities. So depending on the type of job, these abilities, requirement of these abilities varies from job position to position. Hope you have understood whatever we have discussed so far. So we have discussed about abilities, we have discussed about different, okay, what is organization. So now let's check our progress. My first question is, the five fundamental concepts that revolve around the nature of people are, please write here whatever you have found so far. Then the second question is, organizational behavior is related to which situations? And then third is, define organizational behavior. So thank you very much. See you again with my another video lecture.